Okay, I'm two in a row.
Well, I tried.
You got all this popular, it's a real good mic check, and I'll write it in here like a bad man.
At this point, we do not have any official injury and updates to bring you, and we are only now beginning to put together the pieces of this horrible incident.
All right, just a few seconds ago, we were tuning in to one of our affiliates in New York, WNYW. Right now, we want to go to an eyewitness on the telephone right now. Jean, what can you tell us about what you saw?
I can tell you that I was watching TV, and there was this sonic boom, and the TV went out, and maybe with the Concorde is back in service, because I heard about those sonic booms, and I got up to my window. I live in Battery Park City, right next to the Twin Towers, and I looked up, and the sign of the World Trade Center exploded right when I looked up, and at that point, debris started falling. I couldn't believe what I was watching.
Can you hear anything from your position right now? Ambulances, sirens?
Absolutely, positively. There are crowds of people downstairs in Battery Park City. Everybody's come out from the buildings. This is the financial area in Manhattan. And there's a lot of fire engines. I can see them from my window.
Jane, can you tell us, I don't know if you can tell which tower it is that's on fire right now, or the kinds of services that are inside that tower?
I can't tell what's inside. It's the northern tower versus the southern tower. And it seems
what guy?
That guy. The old guy?
Absolutely.
737. Straight into fucking jumbo jet.
Dead. People. Got
it. Okay, John.
We're going to eventually try this again. This time it might make a little more sense. This is center IP in the center, Mike.
People in that area who may have been
you listening?
Hit by any of this debris, or were not able to get out of the way. Can you see any crowds that may be too close to where they should be?
This is mic number one.
It's not a highly trafficked area.
Two, three.
I
just reran these cables.
Oh, all right. You want to redo everything from the beginning?
Look at pictures of this devastating scene. According to Sean Murtaugh, Vice President of Finance, he witnessed what he described as a twin engine plane, possibly a 737. He was almost absolutely sure that it was a large passenger jet that went into that plane. Jane, you're saying that you didn't see anything initially. You didn't see a plane actually approach the building.
I had no idea it was a plane. I just saw the entire...
Hey, Jerry, your camera's up, Jerry.
I know. World Trade Center explode.
Can we go on the roof?
Oh, no, your camera's not up. You just said that. Yeah, everybody's out there.
Really strange.
Were you there living in New York during the World Trade Center bombing?
No, I wasn't.
Unfortunately, so when you say a sonic boom, did you actually feel anything shaking in your apartment?
You could feel it. It was just a gigantic sonic boom. The TV nearly it went off for a second, and then it went back on. And the windows, you felt the vibrations on the windows.
You were saying it's not a high traffic area usually, but can you guesstimate how many people may be in an area like that at this hour of the morning?
It would be hard to say. There is a huge courtyard between the two World Trade Center buildings, and the only issue might have been tourists or business people out in this courtyard area, and they possibly would have been hit. But the people that are immediately around the base of the World Trade Center, I would say at any given time, you're talking about maybe 20 or 30 people at best.
There's some fucking journal out there, but I can't help them.
Not normally an area where you would see some sort of aircraft.
That's
certainly
obvious. Dude, don't even try and go on the roof. I got told to go on the roof. Dude, the guy won't let us out there. I went to go help him.